In this video, we're going to talk about conditional and biconditional statement. A conditional statement is simply a statement that can be written in if-then form. And we use this symbol to represent it. And we say, the way we read it is, if P, then Q. Or P implies Q. Okay? And the hypotheses, make sure I spelled it right. The hypothesis is the phrase immediately following the word if. So if you have trouble understanding hypotheses, another word is assumption. So if I assume something, then something else will happen, right? And the conclusion is the phrase immediately following the word then. So if I have an assumption, then I have a conclusion. That's how I remember it. So here's an example. If you live in Nashville, then you live in Tennessee. So we have an if here, we have an and there. And so we said whatever follows if is the hypothesis, and whatever follows the then, you have your conclusion. So your hypothesis is you live in Nashville. And your conclusion is you live in Tennessee. Right? So the next example, if the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degrees, then they are complementary angles. So again, we have an if-then statement. So we've got our hypotheses and our conclusions. So our hypothesis is the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degrees. The conclusion is that they are complementary angles. There we go. Third one, if a quadrilateral is a square, if you don't know what quadrilateral is, it's basically a shape that's made of four lines, like rectangle or a square. So if a quadrilateral is a square, then it has four right angles. So again, I have an if, I have a then. So here's my hypotenuse, and here's my conclusion. So the hypotenuse is quadrilateral is a square. So my conclusion is it has four right angles. I'm just using some symbols to shorten my sentences, but make sure that you write it all out, just easier for you to read. Okay, so below it's some examples, and it's given us asking us to write some if-then statements. So number four, an obtuse angle has a measure greater than 90 degrees. So we can say if an angle is obtuse, then our conclusion is it has a measure greater than 90 degrees. Okay, number five, all numbers divisible by 4 are also divisible by 2. So if we put in an if-then statement is, if a number is divisible by 4, is divisible by 4, then our conclusion is It is also divisible. It is divisible by 2. Right? So using logic. Number 6, states on the East Coast border the Atlantic Ocean. So the conclusion of that is if a state is on the East Coast, like New Jersey, if a state is on the East Coast, then it borders the Atlantic Ocean. Okay. Number 7, Valentine's Day is in February. So the statement would be if it is Valentine's Day, then it is February. So make your if and then statement. I'm not going to write it out. Number 8, prime numbers only have 2 factors, 1 and itself. So the if then statement is if a number is prime, then its only 2 factors are 1 and itself. So under conditional statements, there are also subcategories that we can that can help us draw various conclusions. So first of all, let's look at inverse. Inverse is formed by negating the hypothesis and the conclusion. So, and what we do is when we make a negation, if you recall from the last unit, we use that weakly, and we say not P. If not P, then not Q, right? So converse is formed by switching the hypotheses and the conclusion. So all I need to do is to switch if Q, then P. And contrapositive is formed by negating and switching. So I have to do both the hypotheses and the conclusion. So so rather than saying if P then Q, I say if not Q then not P. Notice it's 2 steps. I first have to negate both statements, and then secondly I switch both statements. So let's look at some examples here. If it is a Saturday, then it's no school. So the inverse, like we said, it's simply to negate both statements. So if it's not Saturday, then we have to negate the conclusion. Then there is no school. Double negative makes a positive. Then there is school. Okay? So notice that the original was a negation, and after we negate a negation, double negative makes a positive. And the truth value is this would be false, because don't forget we have Sunday. Saturday is probably my favorite day, but Sunday is a close second. So that's the inverse, that you're just simply negating both the hypotheses and the conclusion. The converse, you have to switch it. So you can say if, right? Again, Saturday, what comes after Saturday is P. What comes after if is P. What comes after then is Q. So now I switch it. So if I say if there is no school, switch the original statement, then it's Saturday. Obviously, this is false as well, because Sunday has no school too. Now, contrapositive is we have to switch it and then we have to negate it. So what I usually do is I just simply take the converse and then I negate the converse. So under the converse, notice that this part is already a negation, so I have to do a double negative. So if there's no school, the opposite of that is If there is school, then, now I have to negate what's after then. Then it's not Saturday, right? And this, this is true. If there is school, then it's not Saturday. So we can also say if there's no school, then it's not Sunday. That's also a true statement. However, we're only concerned about Saturday. So this part is challenging to some students, but I suggest that you just stay focused on the if-then statement. So if P, then Q, right? You can also express it with these symbols. And then remember, inverse is simply if not P, then not Q. And for converse, I switch the P and Q first, and then I negate them. So you have to understand this part here. Then the rest of it is just formulaic. It follows the same pattern. So let's do one more. Number two, if the product of two numbers is odd, then both numbers must be odd. So this part is our P and this part is our Q statement. So inverse, I just need to switch it. So I say I just need to negate it. If the product of two numbers is not odd or is even, then both numbers must be even. You can also say if the product is not odd, then both numbers must not be odd. So that's another way of expressing the same thing, and both are correct. And obviously this is false. So if I have to give you an example, is 4 times 7. Let's see. The next one is a converse. Converse is simply switching the P statement and the Q statement, the hypothesis and the conclusion. So if two numbers are odd, then their product is odd. And this obviously is true. The contrapositive is you can go back to the original statement and make sure you negate both statements and then you switch both statements. But I just take, especially when they have inverse, converse, and contrapositive like this, I often just take the converse. And then all I need to do is just to negate that. So if two numbers are, in this case, even, because that's the opposite of odd, then their product must be or is even as well. And this we know is true, right? So for number three, do that practice on your own, and the answer key is posted online as well. Let me see what's after this. Oh, biconditional statement. I think I'm gonna make a separate video for biconditional statement because this one is a long one. Okay, guys? And I'll see you in class. Bring questions to class if you have any. Bye.